Yo, Cleverlike here with another tutorial on creating your own Minecraft add-ons for the Pocket Edition and Windows 10 Edition of Minecraft. This time we're going to be talking about loot tables. Loot is when objects, like entities, drop items when they are killed or when they die. It's also related to the items that spawn in the various chests that are inside the world, and even pertains to fishing. So, without further ado, let's get started on customizing the loot for our own game by creating a custom behavior pack. Now, if you are unfamiliar with the process, you might want to watch my Getting Started video, which is for beginners, or the Quick Start video, which is for people that are a little more experienced with code. And I'm going to go through the process here. I'm going to go through it fairly quickly, though. Okay, so I've got the download started. If I go to my downloads folder, you could see here that I've got the vanilla behavior pack. Okay, so I'm going to right click on that. I say extract all. Now there's lots of different ways to do this, but this is the way I like to do it. And we're going to call it crazy loot. That's our folder. And I'm going to extract everything into that folder, into the behavior pack folder. Okay, great. So now we have our vanilla version of the behavior packs installed, and now what we're going to do is open up our code editor. I'm using Microsoft's Visual Studio Code, which is a free download, and I'm going to open the folder. So I'm going to open that entire behavior pack folder. So I click on Crazy Loot, and then I say Select Folder. So now I have access to every file really quickly here, and what we're going to start with is the manifest file. This is important to change every time you create a new behavior pack or resource pack. The reason is that these UUIDs need to be unique for every single project that you make, okay? So every single UUID needs to be unique, with the exception of when you're connecting a dependent resource pack to your behavior pack, and then at which point those need to match each other, so the dependency needs to match on the resource pack manifest. In this case, the first thing I'll do is delete this because we're not going to be attaching a resource pack to this. Resource packs are the textures and models that go with the different entities, but we're not going to be customizing any of the visuals today, just the loot behaviors. So we've got that deleted, and now we need to go grab two unique IDs. So I've created a nice simple web page that creates UUIDs for you. As soon as you go to the web page, it will generate a new unique UUID, and we could take that first one and paste it in here, and then go back and refresh the page and go there. So make sure you don't copy mine. Go get your own. They're free and they're completely unique to you every time you refresh the page. Okay, now I'm going to give the behavior pack a name, and we'll call this guy Crazy Loot. Crazy Loot, and then I'm going to copy this description line from here and paste it here. Okay, and then we can call this Modified Loot Tables by Cleverlike. Okay, cool, and then we'll call this the Crazy Loot Behavior Pack. Okay, and it's got its own unique ID, version number, so everything's set here. So now Minecraft should recognize this behavior pack. And now what we could start doing is going and examining the different loot tables. Now keep in mind, when you're making a behavior pack, you only want to include the things that you're actually changing. So this vanilla pack that we included has all of the files. I like that because it helps me know what my options are. But when we're getting ready for prime time, we're going to want to delete anything that we did not change because that's already included with the game. So you don't want to send that again as part of your behavior pack. You only want to send the behaviors that you modified. So in this case, we'll probably be leaving the entities alone, and we'll just be focusing on the loot tables. So we're going to go here and let's see. Let's poke through these. You see the chests here. We've got abandoned mineshaft, desert pyramid, end city, igloo, jungle temple. Right? You see these are all of the different areas on the map that spawn a chest. And so we could see kind of how those chests spawn here. So if we were to go into like a jungle temple, you could see the loot that gets put into those chests when it's generated. Okay, and we'll go through how that works. We'll hide that and then look at entities. Now, these are your different entities. So when these die or when they're killed, they will have some form of drops. So we're familiar with cows, right? Cows will drop leather here or beef. And you can see there's some additional items there. We'll explain how that works as part of the process. And then there's also the gameplay, which is the fishing to modify. So we're going to focus on the entities today because that's going to be the easiest thing to recreate. And you'll get an understanding of how loot tables work. And then you could experiment in the different areas to make your own custom behavior pack for your own ideas. So let's focus on the cow for right now, right? So let's take a look here at this cow. One of the things I want to do is copy all this code. I'm going to take it to my little code editor, the JSON editor that I have on my website that makes it a little easier to see. Now, here's the same exact code, but when I send it over here, we could take a look at it. So in the loot tables, we have, first of all, the concept of pools, which is kind of like what gets delivered upon the drop based on what these outcomes are. So the first item here has a number of roles, which is defined as one role. So it's going to have one chance to pick something from these entries. Now, in this case, there's only one entry, right? So it's going to pick a leather item. And then these are some of the conditions that are going to be set upon that. So the first one is the count. So how many leather will get dropped when you kill a cow. Now, do you always get leather? And what's the most leather you've ever gotten? Well, here's the answer right here. So the minimum would be zero. So it's possible that you'll get zero leather, or the most you'll get is two leather when you drop. So that's kind of what processes through whenever it's time to make a drop for a cow, is this loot table. And then there's an enchantment effect as well, which is going to be a random between zero and one. So it's going to affect the looting enchantment. So we are going to, with that, put that aside here, and now we'll look at this other one. So what's the other thing we get from cows? We get beef, right? So in here we've got, again, one roll, which is basically one pass through the list, and it's going to pick beef, and we've got the count, which is 1 to 3, so you'll always get beef, but you'll only get 1 to 3 beef depending on what was randomized. And the other cool thing is the furnace smelting effect. So it's going to add a smelting effect, which is cooking the beef, in which case the property of the cow is on fire. So if the cow is on fire when you kill it, then it's actually going to smelt the beef, which you'll get steak. So your outcome will be steak with the beef that was selected there. So that's kind of interesting. That's a rule. You can control that. And then, again, the looting enchantment between 0 and 1 is also an option there. Okay, so that is a quick overview of how this works. And we can go ahead and change that. So let's just go ahead and make a quick change to this. We'll make an obvious change. So we'll set the minimum leather count to 20 and the maximum to 50. Okay, so we're always going to get, we're going to get one shot at it, and we're going to get somewhere between 20 to 50 for each cow that we kill. And let's see here, we have the next one is beef. And here we can get, like, let's get like 30 to 35, somewhere between 30 and 35. All right, cool. And so what I'm going to do is send this code back over here. The nice thing about this editor is it's really easy to read. You see how it does away with a lot of all these curly braces and square brackets and things. It takes care of all the formatting for you, so you could just focus on the code. And then it'll generate the correct code. So you could see here is our correct code with 30 to 35 and our 20 to 50. So with all of that selected, I'm going to Control A and then Control C to copy it. We'll go back to our code editor over here. I paste it in place and then I save it. And then one of the things I'm going to do is quit out of Minecraft and I'm going to go back into it from the beginning. Okay, and so we are looking at playing. We'll set up a new world. Loot world. And then we'll call it, we could call it survival. That sounds fun. We're going to turn sheets on. And first of all, we have to go and add our behavior pack. So do we have crazy loot? Yep, we sure do. There it is. I clicked. Now it's added into my game. So we're ready to use that. So let's go ahead and click create. And let's hope for cows. Well, hello. All right. Where are we? Let's find some cows. Where's the mooers? Okay, so here we have some cows here. Well, hello. And it's going to be a battle. It's going to be a battle here. So, okay. There's our loot. Let's see if it worked here. There we go. And let's hit E and click on this guy here. Look at that. 34 raw beef and 38 leather. Wow. Wow, we are set. I don't even need you. I could spare you. I have so much steak here. Well, I have raw beef, but I can go get some steak. You will be spared today. Cool, and that's going to wrap up this quick tutorial on customize your own loot tables. Now, there's lots more stuff to customize, and I'm going to go over more details in future videos. So make sure you subscribe if you want to see more videos like this. Give a like if this was helpful to you. And also post in the comments any videos that you'd like to see, anything that you'd like to learn or that you're having trouble with. Post them in the comments, and I'll see if I can help you out. I'm going to post links to everything I used in the description below, so make sure to check that out. I've also got links to some more information defining how loot tables are structured. So if you want some more reading, I'll put some links in there as well, and that'll give you some more information on where to go for learning more about loot tables in the meantime. But until next time, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.